माय टॉपिक इज को करिकुलर एक्टिविटीज एटीट्यूड एंड पार्टिसिपेशन ऑफ सेकेंडरी स्कूल स्टूडेंट. दिस पेपर इज आल्सो मेड बाय मी एंड माय डॉटर इशिता कोठारी. शी इज रिसर्च फेलो इन यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ महारानी कॉलेज जयपुर इंडिया एंड आई एम सुरेंद्र कोठारी प्रेजेंटिंग माई पेपर. को करिकुलर एक्टिविटीज मीन्स एक्टिविटीज कंडक्टेड ऑन ऑफ स्कूल प्रीमिसेस बाय क्लब एसोसिएशन एंड ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ऑफ पीपल स्पॉन्सर्ड बाय द बोर्ड ऑफ एजुकेशन. को करिकुलर एक्टिविटीज ऑल्सो इंक्लूड द पीपल क्लब एसोसिएशन एंड ऑर्गेनाइजेशन द कॉन्टेक्ट दोज एक्टिविटीज. बट को करिकुलर एक्टिविटीज डज नॉट इंक्लूड एथलेटिक कॉम्पिटिशन और प्रैक्टिस एथलेटिक टीम और ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. दीज एक्टिविटीज आर वेरियसली नेम्ड एज एक्स्ट्रा करिकुलर एक्टिविटीज. मैनी सेकेंडरी स्कूल करेंटली यूज द टर्म स्कूल लाइफ एक्टिविटीज. इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ को करिकुलर एक्टिविटीज फॉर द स्टूडेंट. दिस गिवज देम कॉन्फिडेंस. स्टूडेंट कैन लर्न टीम स्पिरिट ब्रिंग ए पॉजिटिव चेंज इन द चाइल्ड. स्टूडेंट विल गेट अ चांस टू शार्पन द टैलेंट टू डेवलप ऑल द राउंड पर्सनैलिटी ऑफ द स्टूडेंट. को करिकुलर एक्टिविटीज आर टू कीप a student physically active. There are some impact of extracurricular activity on student. There is some impact on art of a student and music of the student, drama, environment, sports. In arts, improve motor skill, develop problem solving skill, encourage self expression, encourage creativity, encourage acceptance of others. Music. In music, improve coordination, encourage concentration, develop patience, improve self-confidence, help in relaxation of mind and body. In drama, when a student part in drama, then improve language skill, teaches empathy, help development of moral sense, improve long-term memory, develop public speaking abilities. In environment activities, improve social awareness, improve reading abilities, encourage sustainable life chances, choices, encourage creativity. When a student participates in the sports activities, teaches coordination, improve overall health, improve reflexes, build strength, teaches some work. Scope of co-curricular activities. The scope of co-curricular activities is wide due to nearly inexhaustible list of interest. Put platform to the secure the future both professionally and social promote leadership quality. Co-curricular activity are great source of developing students interest in studies in classroom and school routine. It nurtures student ability in cooperation, coordination, organization and lead towards leadership. These activities prepare a child for future challenges. Role of co-curricular activity in the student life. It enhances inner confidence to make student fit for the future time, enhance social interaction, healthy recreation and self-discipline. Co-curricular activities are the true and practical experience received by the student. Physical activity like running, football, etc. help not only in the physical fitness, they also refresh the burdened mind. Types of co-curricular activities: academic development activities, aesthetic development activities, cultural development activities. In academic development activities include surveys, quizzes, project preparation of chart models, school magazine, essay writing, story writing, and subject club like that. Social science club, geographical club, commerce club, etc. Aesthetic development activities, music, dramatic exhibition, decoration, fancy flower festival, painting and drawing. These are the aesthetic development activities. Cultural development activities, social service, student council, youth parliament, first aid, etc. Guideline for co-curricular activities. Co-curricular activities. Programs shall opportunity for the student to prepare themselves for successful participation in society through the development, improvement and performance of interpersonal and intrapersonal skill. Therefore, as a result of opportunity of, or involvement in co-curricular program, the participant learner will be, the student will possess positive feel, develop a plan for raising self-worth and share in the role-playing activities. Conclusion, since all kind of development, physical, social, emotional and psychological are taking place almost simultaneously and the effect of development of one aspect has a bearing on the development of other aspects, it becomes pertinent to ensure all-round development of the adolescent child and hence the need of co-curricular activities. Further, these activities channel their energies to proper direction. These activities give adolescent a feeling of competence and self-confidence and help them develop useful, enjoyable skill. It may be music, sport, rock climbing or any other hobby that may interest them. Hence, the researcher felt the need of study, the attitude and preparation in co-curricular activity of secondary school people to gain insight into existing practices and their outcome and their influence on the overall development of a child. Thanks. Any question?
Hello, sir.
Aji.
Yes, sir. Can you hear me? Okay, okay.
Yes.
I think I am audible. Last lecture, I am not audible. So you are explaining very good manner, sir, and in details. आपने बहुत अच्छा प्रेजेंट किया है और आपने जो स्कूल का लिया है, स्कूल में अभी जो हो रहा है, अभी तक तो कुछ हो रहा नहीं था, पर आपने जो एक्सप्लेन किया है वो अभी उससे काफी ज्यादा, ये पेपर कभी उन लोगों ने किया तो उसमें ज्यादा डेवलप कर सकते हैं, तो बहुत सारा एक्सप्लेन किया सर आपने. थैंक यू सर, थैंक यू फॉर प्रेजेंटिंग योर रिसर्च पेपर.
थैंक यू सर, थैंक यू.
वेरी नाइस प्रेजेंटेशन सर.
थैंक यू सर.
Manoj, you also presented a very good papers. And as I am your supervisor, so I am not ask you questions. The audience should be asked questions. So as a PhD Viva, guide should not answer, ask questions. So guide can correct them if anything.
Sir, there is a question-like presentation.
No, sir.
Manoj's
first conference is I think it was there in Bangkok, right? Bangkok, right? He was joined in the PhD and I was also there in that conference, and the first conference, first paper, he got the best paper award. So yeah, that much expertise he is having. So we are very proud, Manoj Jain, you are here.
Sir, I'm also feel up very proud.
Because of your efforts, sir, he is making the breakthroughs.
Actually, honestly, credit definitely goes to my mentors and to you, Dr. Prakash Divakaran, sir, for giving me exposure to to continue and get through this doctorate program. You showed me the way out, and you are I have no words to say inspiration, because I am nothing in front of you, because it is easy to grow when you are with gems or scholars surrounded around you, so the way we say.
Thank you.
Yes, sir.
Yeah,
the confidence.
Now there are so many research students are attending this conference. They need to observe the proceedings and all. So I request these participants to ask some questions, because Dr. Adul Ramgade sir is there, then Dr. Prakash Karmadkar sir from Pune University, then Surendra Kothari sir from Rajasthan University, and all experts are available. I think Dr. Girish Kumar sir also is there. Then Dr. Reshma Patani is available. So if you want, you can ask some questions related to research or research methodology or whatever may be related to research. So they will be very happy to answer you. Reshma or Krishnan, you can also ask. Rani Rajni ma'am, you can ask some questions related to research so that it will be an eye opening to others as well.
Are you there?
Yeah, yeah, everybody is there.
So,
Rani Rajni ma'am, as you said, Reshma R. Krishnan ma'am. And we welcome actually Dr. Reshma Pathan on board as well today.
Mr. Sahil Patil, you are having any questions related to research methodology? He is a PG student and he presented two papers last conference. Now he is attending the conference.
No, sir, not at such any.
Okay, okay.
Thank you so much.
Okay.
Yes, we remember Sahil Patil, sir. Remember presenting in the very in a proper prescribed time format. Very nice presentations were done by Sahil Patil.
Yes, Rani ma'am. You can ask related to any basic questions, no problem.
Excuse me, sir. Can I ask something to Prakash sir?
Yes. Yes, sir.
Prakash,
yes, sir.
Prakash sir, can you hear me?
Yeah,
yes,
sir.
Yes.
Good afternoon. I ask about the journals.
Journal publication.
Journal publication. More of the students have a problem to publish their paper in Scopus or UGC listed journal. But you know, there is no specific criteria to see that the journal are listed or not. How to prove the journal is originally listed in UGC, because you are belongs to the Savitri Bai Phule University. So I ask the process of the listing and the proving the journal is UGC listing and that journal is original journal, not a clone journal. How will the student decide?
The question is to actually Prakash Karmarkar sir, yep. But before Prakash Karmarkar sir, I will add something. Actually, as per the UGC guidelines, peer-reviewed journals, oblique UGC care journals.
Yeah.
Remember, peer-reviewed journals and UGC care journals, oblique Scopus indexed journals. So like that way, the guidelines of UGC is there. But the people all are behind UGC care list, and the people are very much worried about that. And there are so many only printed journals are available in India right now. The printed journals and the printed journals also, some of the journals are coming in the clone categories. So right now nobody can predict which one is, because this month you have published, next month that journal is going to be in clone list or UGC is removing them. So these are the situations that are happening. If you are talking about Scopus indexed journals, all Scopus indexed journals are UGC listed journals. So whenever you are publishing the article, the same time, same moment it is available in the Scopus list, it is approved. Or the UGC care journal, you are publishing an article. For example, in the month of July, you are publishing an article. The journal is available in Scopus. index or in UGC care list, the article is approved. And now one more thing, the peer-reviewed journals. Peer-reviewed journals means that journals are there are so many are available in India. Online journals are there. So that journals, if you are publishing also, no university, no supervisor can deny your API score or your PhD scholar status. Okay. So please remember that. Just UGC care, don't behind on that. You can even publish the article in peer-reviewed journals, international journals, and you will get the API score itself. Then all Scopus indexed journals are by default UGC approved list.
And sir, Prakash, regarding publication in book, in so many seminars, international, national, they publish a book, compilation of research papers with the ISBN number.
Yeah, that is also approved.
That can be equal to UGC care or Scopus index or this peer reviewed, because these also undergoes peer review.
Yeah. Actually, the conference publication as such is concerned, the ISBN number, books publication, how much value you are getting in the API score. Similarly, the ISBN listed book, the article publication is also good. The conference proceedings are also similarly, because once the paper comes, we are going through the peer review. After the review, the paper will be accepted and the acceptance letter will be coming to the scholars. Then the scholar will come, if there is any correction, they are doing the corrections and resubmitting the paper. Then the conference will be done. Then the people are presenting in the conference. So that proceedings are coming in ISBN number is also getting value. But the only problem is that in API score, if it is a conference proceeding, the points will be lesser.
Two types of conference publications are there. One is proceedings. The another institution publishes a book. For example, your college or your global science and research conference forum is publishing a book consisting of 15 articles from 15 authors with the ISBN after undergoing a peer review process.
Yeah. It is approved.
That book can be treated equal to care listed or peer reviewed one, sir.
That is considered as peer reviewed.
I'm asking this question only because the many PhD students come to us and ask that. Sir, during the PhD work, they have to do some publications, two publications on their PhD topic. So today, see, my PhD research scholar has presented a paper on relevant to his own PhD topic in this seminar. So it is getting published in the proceedings or book or journal.
No, actually, we are publishing in UGC care or Scopus journal, because when we are doing through that process, the students will get the full marks, full credit. And the faculties, those who are submitting the paper, will get the API score very well. So that is why we are doing this, collecting the paper through the conference, but it is publishing through the UGC care or Scopus journals.
Okay. So if one is having an article or a research paper in a book with ISBN, peer-reviewed book, or Scopus index, or peer-reviewed journal, he need not worry about further UGC care list.
Yes, rightly. So
I'm having a notification after this conference. I will send you all, so you can go through that. The clarifications are very clearly there with the UGC that I will publish.
Because PhD scholars always have this doubt. They come as repeatedly. Karmakar sir, please.
Yes. As Dr. Prakash has rightly said that the conference proceeding is also considered. Conference proceeding also considered, and they are also be included in the NAC criteria third. That is the recognition and extension program.
The only problem is only presentation or publication. One can be taken for both.
You can take another both. As per right, sir is rightly says, he can take in the journals. It is a very good to take in a journal manner. Some conference say they are publishing their own. that will be also considering. But as far as faculty wise concerned, a faculty should be more get marks on that as per sir's wish. They are publishing journals. It is my humble request, sir's given the proper as a proper answer and proper justice to our faculties also.
Yeah. And one more thing, if you are having 10 Scopus publication, 10 Scopus publication in the sense with a good indexed journals, peer-reviewed international journals, you will get a US visa. You know, somebody knows that, I don't know. The 10 papers, if you in your credit, 10 papers as a first author, if you are having Scopus publication, then you will get a free US visa. And some countries are getting that criteria. You are working as a professor and all, you can go as a faculty, visiting faculty and all, that is the criteria for US.
Thanks, sir. You are sharing very good information for our faculty members' betterments.
So, you see, Mr. Manoj Jain is there with us. He is a Canadian, citizen with Asper passport status. So when he is staying in India for his completing his PhD. Once he completed the PhD, he is supposed to go back. Then how much presentations he has done, how many conferences he has attended, like that way he is going to get the benefits. So please remember that you people can work sometimes after the retirement also, visiting faculty, go to some foreign universities to maintain 10 purpose and all. And whenever you are publishing the paper, please go through the editorial policies and all, the paper template, the styles and all. Because once the review will be coming, you are publishing the paper, but the paper is not having any meaning, then it will not be considered later also, if it is Scopus or anything. Because nowadays paid journals are there, so they will publish as it is, whatever it will be. So, but you have to maintain.